so wonderful to be here with you today, just a day before strawberry. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This isn't your first strawberry, is it?
Nope. I've been to each one. There've been four total. This is the fourth, I believe, yeah.
And you've been in every strawberry.
Mm-hmm.
So, Eric, we want to know about the music. Mm. You're a musician. You mentioned that, you know, you're a headliner at this time, Strawberry. Tell us about the music. Tell us what music means to you.
Yeah.
What are you going to be, how many numbers are you going to be doing? Do you know, or is it? Just tell us anything.
Well, I'm actually going through quite a transition with music, because I don't really know what my set is going to look like. About 9 years ago in 2009, I took a big leap of faith where I was guided to let go of my career at that time, a hypnotherapy career, and be a traveling minstrel, where I was just guided to travel or live in community or just basically blow with the wind wherever I was guided to share. And at that time, songs just began to pour through me. And the first song that came to me was a song that I needed, because I was so scared of what was going to happen to me if I didn't, you know, if I was just a traveling minstrel. I thought, well, I might just end up homeless or something.
The fear.
Yeah, the fear. But the first song that came to me was called Just Relax.
There you go.
And it was something that I started to sing over and over.
Where are you today with your music? How has your music changed in the last 9-10 years? And what do you bring to Strawberry this time?
Well, wow, that's big. I feel like I just had a talk with Kirsten, because I was sharing with her initially that I don't feel connected anymore to my old songs in a way. I've been playing them for years. I love them still, but I was sharing with her that I felt that I'd liked for new songs to come through me, but it hasn't happened. There's been a couple new songs, but they're not the kind of songs that I feel really, really deeply. So she just basically let me express all that. And then when we were done, when I got it all out, then I suddenly felt like, wow, it's totally cool. It's all going to be perfect. Mm. I actually do feel inspired to play my old songs now, because I know they're going to have be very meaningful for others who've never heard them, and for the people who have. And I feel that new songs will begin to come. And maybe I'll even have a whole download right before my day of singing. And so I'm kind of excited.
I feel that, you know? Mm. I feel that you're really, really, the songs are just going to come, and what you've been looking for and what made the tears fall from your eyes before you spoke to Kirsten. Strawberry hasn't even begun. It begins tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe another album. But yeah. Eric, words are not important right now. We want to hear the music. Mm. We want to hear you play.
Oh, sure. Please. I'd love to. Yeah. I'll play you one of the songs that came pretty early on. It's called Rhythm of the Soul. Sometimes I get so afraid of this made-up world I made. But when I trust inside, there's no need to hide my heart, 'cause now I'm living by the rhythm of the soul, and it's calling me home. I'm giving up believing that I really know anything at all.
Oh, Eric. This is Strawberry. It's begun.
Uh-huh.
Thank you so much. It just feels... this is what I came 8,000 miles for.